Right, now I'm going to put some varnish on this now. I'm using B&Q's varnish, quick drying. Yeah, right, still overnight. Actually, I've done some of this on my tool chest. 3 days it took to dry, and it was very light coats, but it's a water-based varnish. It's for interior wood enhancement, so it's not made for exterior one. But they do an exterior water-based varnish as well. Find something to put it in. Let's give that a bit of a brush out there. There we go. Right, when you get it, it's actually a milky substance in here, but it actually dries clear. So again, I use this on my models as well. So load the brush up and just start rubbing it in. I mean rubbing it in. I actually get it rubbed in really well. I can do this with a cloth, which I do sometimes do, as I did with the stain. I give it a good rubbing. I don't make sure I use all that brush up on the wood, but keep rubbing it in. It gives you the decent finish you need. Yeah, I'm going to speed this up now.
To the town of Offic, who rode a stranger one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them held a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his
heel. Now, I've put a good coat over this, as you saw. I've already done this once, but I'm doing it again on the whole piece, running the brush full length of the shelf to get rid of any brush strokes or that in it. Although it doesn't really matter with this, because it's actually quite a self-leveling compound in this, but I like to do it to get a nice even coat on it. And doing this way, any really thick pieces you can pull out, like there's a thick piece there and there, so we're going to pull those out and then carry on doing it long strokes all the way down and back again. And there we go. Right, we're going to leave this for, well, let's actually use the tin's directions. Right, it says 1 hour. So I'm going to leave it 1 hour. It's quite a hot day today, so it shouldn't be too bad. Right, but I'm not going to leave it on the brush for an hour. I'm going to wash this out straight away. As you can see, this brush has almost had it, but I've got to get some new ones, but it'll do the job for this. 1 hour. And we'll come and re-coat it. Right, it's had an hour. Now, I'm going to do 3 coats of this. So, by tonight, I should have had it fully covered, and I'll need to put it somewhere where I can leave it to thoroughly dry overnight and not get any dust on it. But there's one more little stage before we go on to the second coat. Now, this is basically dry. It's a bit rough. It always is when you first put your varnish on. Brings up the grain. So what I do is 150 grit paper and just a quick sand. And I mean a quick sand, you don't need a lot. I'll show you that now. So the whole thing with the grain. Make sure you knock all that top edges off. Right, there we go. Let's put a brush off. All the dust. Right, now we're ready to apply the second coat of varnish. After the second coat has dried for an hour, knock that top off. You can hear it, it's quite smooth now, you see. So you knock the top off on the second coat after an hour. Recoat it with the third coat. Again, knock it back after the third coat has dried. And have a look, see what you've got. Now, if you're still not satisfied with that finish, put a fourth coat on top. Maybe even a fifth coat on top of that. But this time, instead of leaving it just an hour to dry between coats, leave it overnight. Let it really dry with a good surface on it. Come back in the morning and give it a feel. See if you like the finish. If you do, that's it. It's all done. Just needs a bit of wax polish just to protect the coloration and surface. I'm just going to say, be careful when you're working with wood. Well, be careful just working in the workshop. You need to be. We don't want any accidents at all if we can help it. Anyway, that's it for this part. I'll see you soon. Keep safe. Bye for now.